So, ever wondered how to create a basic FPS movement scheme in Unity? It's actually quite easy to do. First of all, you'll want to make sure that you have a game object for your FPS player with the main camera nested inside as a child. The player in itself should have two built-in components. One, a character controller that makes it easy to move a physical object in a Unity scene without having to manually deal with forces and rigid bodies, which can be quite annoying. And two, we'll just give it a C# script called FirstPersonController with the following code. So in here we start by defining some variables for character movement, then we get a few component references, we lock the cursor in the middle of the screen, and in the update hook, we take care of moving and rotating our FPS player based on our current inputs. For the move, it's mainly about applying the gravity if we're not currently grounded, adding an upward velocity if we're pressing the jump input, and then using the horizontal and vertical input axes to get the movement in the XZ plane. We retransform those inputs into the local system of our player to move relative to our current view orientation, and finally we multiply by our speed and the frame delta time to get the proper vector. For the rotation, the trick is to separate the yaw and the pitch between our base player object and the main camera parented to it. Otherwise our code would quickly get messed up with all the rotations. Here we also clamp the vertical rotation before we apply it to the camera. Oh, and just as a reminder, those inputs are defined by default in any Unity project, and you can see what keys they're associated to in your project settings panel. But in any case, that's it! You see that you can now move the camera with your mouse to look around, and then use the built-in inputs to walk in the level relative to the current orientation of the player. You can also jump, and you get properly brought down by gravity, and you can have collisions with the terrain and the other objects. Now, as a side note, if you're actually also a Godot game developer and you want to learn how to do that in Godot, then check out this other video I made on that topic. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to get more game dev content. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and take care!